Advancements in Wi-Fi technology are happening so quickly, it can be difficult to keep them all straight. There's no better example than this than the fact that Wi-Fi 7 was just published in 2024, and we're already starting to talk about Wi-Fi 8. In this episode from Network from Home, we're going to be focusing on Wi-Fi 7 and the advantages that it provides to your home network. And we'll also be talking about whether it's worth upgrading your router so that it supports Wi-Fi 7. So what does Wi-Fi 7 bring to your home network? Speed, speed, and more speed. One of the major features of Wi-Fi 7 is that it offers a 6 gigahertz Wi-Fi network. So in addition to your traditional 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi networks, you'll also have a 6 gigahertz network as well. This 6 gigahertz network was first introduced by the Wi-Fi 6E standard, but Wi-Fi 7 has made improvements to it to make it even faster. So, your 6 gigahertz network, it's shorter range than your 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi networks, but it makes up for it by offering faster speeds than these other two networks. So if you have a device that's close to your router, you can take advantage of this 6 gigahertz network and you'll be experiencing super fast internet speeds as a result. Another really cool feature of Wi-Fi 7 is what's called MLO, or multi-link operation. Traditionally in Wi-Fi networks, your devices, you would have to pick one of the available Wi-Fi networks to connect to. So let's say you had a 2.4 gigahertz network available and a 5 gigahertz network available, your device would have to pick one or the other to connect to. With multi-link operation, your devices can connect to all of these Wi-Fi networks at the same time. So in other words, your mobile phone on your home network, it can connect to the 2.4 gigahertz, the 5 gigahertz, and the 6 gigahertz networks all at the same time. What does this result in? This results in faster bandwidth and faster speeds because your devices can transfer more data using all of these networks at the same time. Another benefit of MLO is that it minimizes the delay or latency of your communications. It does this by ensuring that your devices always have a good Wi-Fi signal. For example, if you have a device and you move it outside of the range of your 6 gigahertz Wi-Fi network, it will still have the 2.4 and 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi networks that it's connected to. Better Wi-Fi signal equals faster speeds and less latency with your communications, so MLO has you covered on both of these fronts. Another main benefit of Wi-Fi 7 is what's called 4K QAM, or 4K quadrature amplitude modulation. I know this is a lot of words here, but basically what it allows you to do is it allows you to send more data per transmission between your devices and your router. Keeping this at a high level, your devices communicate with each other using ones and zeros. What 4K QAM allows you to do is it allows you to pack more ones and zeros into a given transmission between your devices. To be exact, there's about 20% more data you can send with 4K QAM when compared to the earlier versions that Wi-Fi 6 offers. It should be noted that Wi-Fi 5 and Wi-Fi 6 both have QAM, but Wi-Fi 7 offers an improvement over this with the 4K QAM. Good analogy for 4K QAM is, let's say we have a bus that's on the highway, and this bus serves as a transmission between your two devices. This bus, it takes up a certain amount of space on the highway, and it can carry a certain amount of passengers. Well, with 4K QAM, it's basically turning that bus into a double-decker bus. The bus is taking up the same amount of space on the highway, but you can fit that many more passengers on it just because it's a double-decker bus as opposed to a single-layer bus. So essentially, we're taking all this data, we're packing it into the same transmission size, you're just able to move more data at a given point in time. Another advancement of Wi-Fi 7 is the fact that it uses Wi-Fi channels that are twice as wide as the channels that Wi-Fi 6 offers. So when communicating and when broadcasting Wi-Fi networks, your router communicates with other devices using Wi-Fi channels. It's essentially like a handheld radio. you go to a certain channel to talk to somebody else that's on the same channel, and that's how you ensure that you're on the same page and you're talking to the right device. If those devices are on the same channel, they can communicate with each other. And the wider those channels are, the more data that can be sent over those channels. So obviously, if you have a wider Wi-Fi channel, you can transfer more data. It provides your devices with faster speeds when communicating with the internet or other devices. So I'm talking about how all these Wi-Fi 7 features lead to faster speeds. But how much faster are we actually talking? What is the speed that Wi-Fi 7 can support? Well, Wi-Fi 7 has a maximum theoretical speed of 46 gigabits per second. Yes, you heard me correctly. I said 46 gigabits per second. And now that I have your attention, let's pump the brakes right there. The reason for this is that theoretical speed is not the same as real-world speed when we're talking about the speeds that these Wi-Fi versions can support. So although Wi-Fi 7, it says it supports 46 gigabits per second, in real-world tests, we've only seen speeds between 2 and 5 gigabits per second in the real world. With that said, these are crazy fast speeds, especially considering the fact that with Wi-Fi 6E, the real-world tests provided speeds up to 2 gigabits per second, which is the lower range of what's supported by Wi-Fi 7. So it goes without saying, the speeds supported by Wi-Fi 7 are crazy fast. Just don't get excited if you see 46 gigabits per second, because that's just the theoretical speed that's supported by Wi-Fi 7, and it's not in reality what you would experience. So with this crazy fast speed and all these great features of Wi-Fi 7, should you run out and upgrade your router to a Wi-Fi 7 router? Well, not so fast here, because there are some important considerations before you go out and make a decision like that. The first factor, which is always a consideration, is price. Because Wi-Fi 7 is the latest and greatest technology, any Wi-Fi 7 router is going to come at a premium, and it's going to be pretty expensive when compared to other devices that support either Wi-Fi 5 or Wi-Fi 6. If you're looking to upgrade your home network and you have a large budget, this isn't an issue. There should still be competitive offers out there for Wi-Fi 7, but it's just something to keep in mind. Another important consideration here, and it's a big one because it's one of the most common misconceptions about internet speed, is that most internet plans don't support between 2 and 5 gigabits per second, which is the speeds that Wi-Fi 7 supports. So, what I mean here is if your internet plan only provides 1 gigabit per second of speed, and your router supports between 2 and 5 gigabits per second of speed, the maximum speed you're going to have on your home network is 1 gigabit per second of speed. So in saying this, Wi-Fi 7 at this point, for the vast majority of people, is overkill. Many people don't even need 1 gigabit per second of internet speed with their internet plan, so buying a router that supports 2 to 5 gigabits per second of internet speed, really, you're paying for something that you're not even going to be able to use, or you don't need to use, because your internet plan provides slower speeds than 2 to 5 gigabits per second. Another thing to think about here is that many, if not all of your devices, wouldn't even be able to recognize the 6 gigahertz Wi-Fi network that your Wi-Fi 7 router is broadcasting. In order to recognize a 6 gigahertz Wi-Fi network, your devices need a very specific piece of hardware. In other words, the network interface card needs to be able to recognize a 6 gigahertz Wi-Fi network. And the bottom line is the vast majority of devices aren't able to do that currently. With that said, newer devices, they'll have this very specific piece of hardware. They'll be able to recognize 6 gigahertz Wi-Fi networks. But I'd be willing to bet many, if not all of your devices at this time, can't recognize a 6 gigahertz Wi-Fi signal. On top of that, many of the devices in your home probably don't even support Wi-Fi 7 at this time. In order to take advantage of all the features of Wi-Fi 7, you need to have a router that supports Wi-Fi 7, and then any given device needs to support Wi-Fi 7 as well. Of course, as time goes on, all devices will eventually be able to support Wi-Fi 7, so you can get ahead of the curve and future-proof your home network by getting a Wi-Fi 7 router now. And just knowing that once you renew all those, they all support Wi-Fi 7, you won't have to replace the router in your home network. All right, so what's the final verdict? Should you go out and upgrade your router so it supports Wi-Fi 7? Well, honestly, for the vast majority of people, I think Wi-Fi 7 is totally overkill right now. Most people don't have internet plans that support speeds up to 1 gigabit per second, much less the 2 to 5 gigabits per second that Wi-Fi 7 supports. Keep in mind, Wi-Fi 5 can support speeds greater than 1 gigabit per second, so it doesn't make sense to get a Wi-Fi 7 device if a Wi-Fi 5 device will fit the bill. On top of that, the fact that most of your devices won't be able to see that 6 gigahertz Wi-Fi signal that your Wi-Fi 7 router is broadcasting, and the fact that many of your devices don't support Wi-Fi 7, so you wouldn't be able to take advantage of all these features that you're paying for, it just doesn't make sense to make that move right now. Also keep in mind here that over time, the prices of these Wi-Fi 7 routers is going to drop, especially as we start talking about Wi-Fi 8 more and putting Wi-Fi 8 routers onto the market. That's going to decrease the price of the Wi-Fi 7 routers. It's kind of like a new iPhone. The newest iPhones are always more expensive than the older versions, so your Wi-Fi 7 routers, you know they're going to drop in price over time, and especially if you can't take advantage of all their features right now, you should wait until you can take advantage of all those features so you get what you're paying for. With all that said, full disclosure, I recently made the switch to a mesh Wi-Fi network, and in doing so, I got a mesh Wi-Fi network that supports Wi-Fi 7. My reason for this is that eventually I know all my devices will support Wi-Fi 7, and I don't want to have to replace my mesh Wi-Fi system anytime soon, so that made sense for me to make the switch. If you're looking to upgrade your home network anyways, or you need to replace your standalone router, maybe you can go ahead and get a Wi-Fi 7 device just to future-proof your home network and ensure that you don't have to replace that device anytime soon. I'd be very curious to see in the comments section what you think about Wi-Fi 7. Do you think it's worth making the switch now? Have you made the switch? Or are you thinking you're going to wait before you make this change? As always, thanks for checking out this episode from Network From Home, and we'll catch you on the next one.